So, students, today we are going to discuss the rest of the two colligative properties. So, our third colligative property is depression and freezing point. So, first of all, what is freezing point? So, in lower classes, you can say that a freezing point is the temperature at which the liquid freezes. For example, freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. But here, this definition is not sufficient. Here, we define freezing point in terms of vapor pressure. So, the freezing point is the temperature at which the solid and the liquid states of the substance have the same vapor pressure. It is observed that when a non-volatile solute is added to a solvent, the freezing point of solution is always less than that of pure solvent. Let's illustrate it graphically. Plot a graph between vapor pressure versus temperature. So we take vapor pressure along the vertical line and temperature along the horizontal line. So first two lines which we have to draw is same as we draw in the graph of elevation in boiling point. So from graph, it is observed that the curve BC, yellow curve, gives the vapor pressure of pure solvent. And we know that on addition of non-volatile solute to the solvent, the vapor pressure decreases. So the vapor pressure curve for solution is the curve DE, which is shown by red line. The curve AB represents the vapor pressure of solid solvent, which is the new curve AB, that is of frozen solvent. The temperature corresponding to the point B, where the solid and liquid solvent meet, represents the freezing point temperature of pure solvent, TF0. The temperature corresponding to the point D, where the solid solvent and liquid solution meets, represent the freezing point temperature of solution, TF. Since TF, that is the freezing point of solution, is less than TF0, this shows that freezing temperature of the solution is less than that of pure solvent, and the depression in freezing point delta TF is given as delta TF is equal to TF0 minus TF. It has been determined experimentally that the depression in freezing point of a solution is proportional to the molar concentration of the solution. That is, delta TF is proportional to small m, that is the molality, or delta TF is equal to KFm, where KF is the proportionality constant and is called the molar freezing point depression constant or molar cryoscopic constant. So if we have to define the KF, then how we can define KF as, if molality is equal to 1, that is unity, then delta TF is equal to KF. Thus, molar freezing point depression constant is defined as the depression in freezing point for one molar solution, that is a solution containing 1 gram moles of solute dissolved in 1000 gram solvent. As depression in freezing point delta TF is directly proportional to the molar concentration of the solute, thus it's a colligative property. So our next topic is how we can determine the molar mass of solute from depression in freezing point. Let WB gram of non-volatile solute is dissolved in WA gram of solvent, and capital MB is the molar mass of solute. Therefore, molality of solution is small m is equal to number of moles of solute divided by weight of solvent in grams multiplied by 1000. Moles of solute NB is equal to weight of solute divided by molecular weight. So molality formula becomes small m is equal to WB upon MB into WA multiplied by 1000. Substitute the value of small m in equation delta TF is equal to KFM. We get delta TF is equal to KF into WB upon MB into WA multiplied by 1000. So by rearranging this formula, we can easily calculate capital MB, that is the molecular mass of solute, which is equal to KF into WB upon delta TF into WA multiplied by 1000. So let's discuss what are antifreeze solutions. So as we know, water is used in radiators of vehicles. So to avoid the freezing of water in radiators of vehicles where temperature is less than zero, that means the areas where temperature becomes less than zero, certain substances are added. So as we already know that by adding a non-volatile solute to a solvent, the freezing point decreases. Thus, the solution formed is called antifreeze solution. For example, ethylene glycol is added in water to lower the freezing point of water. Freeze, common salt, NaCl or calcium chloride are used to clear snow on the roads by decreasing the freezing point of water. Let's try one numerical related to depression and freezing point. What mass of ethylene glycol, whose molecular mass is given 62 gram per mole, must be added to 5.50 kg of water to lower point of water from 0 degree Celsius to minus 10 degree Celsius? So KF for water is given 1.86 Kelvin kilogram per mole. So let's see what is given to us. So weight of water, that is solvent WA, is given 5.50 kilogram, or we can say that 5500 gram. Molecular mass of solute, capital MB, which is also given 62 gram per mole of ethylene glycol. So the lowering in freezing point delta TF is 0 degree Celsius to minus 10 degree Celsius. That comes out to be 10 degree Celsius, or we can say that 10 Kelvin, because the difference of magnitude between the two quantities is always same irrespective of their units. So according to depression and freezing point, delta TF is equal to KF into WB upon MB into WA multiplied by 1000. So from this formula, we can easily find out WB by rearranging it. It is equal to delta TF into MB into WA divided by KF into 1000, which is equal to 10, that is delta TF, into 62, that is the molecular mass of solute, into 5500, that is the weight of solvent, divided by 1.86, that is KF, into 1000. That comes out to be 1833.3 gram, or 1.8333 kilogram. So our fourth and the last colligative property is osmotic pressure, which is related to the term osmosis. So what is osmosis? It is the phenomena of the flow of solvent through a semi-permeable membrane from pure solvent to the solution side is called osmosis. So let's consider an aqueous solution of sugar placed in an inverted thistle funnel having a semi-permeable membrane attached to its bottom. The thistle funnel is lowered into a beaker containing water. The membrane is such that it allows only solvent molecules to pass through it, not the solute particles. Thus, there will be the movement of water molecules from pure solvent into the solution. As a result, water passes into the thistle funnel and the pressure in the thistle funnel rises gradually. This is called osmosis. So here are some differences between diffusion and osmosis. So first is, in case of osmosis, it can take place through semi-permeable membrane, while no such semi-permeable membrane is required in diffusion. Second, in osmosis, it involves the movement of solvent molecules only. But in case of diffusion, both solute and solvent molecules can move. Third, in case of osmosis, the solvent molecules move from the region of lower concentration to higher concentration. But in case of diffusion, the molecules move from region of higher concentration to lower concentration. So osmosis is limited to solutions only, while diffusion is common in liquids and gases. So osmosis can be stopped or reversed by applying external pressure on the higher concentration side. But diffusion cannot be stopped or reversed. Nature has provided many such membranes, both in plants and animals, for specific functions. But semi-permeable membrane can also be prepared in laboratories. For example, film of gelatinous precipitates of cupric ferrocyanide Cu2FeCN6 is an example of artificial semi-permeable membrane. So, to understand the concept of osmotic pressure, let's consider an apparatus consists of two vessels connected by a semi-permeable membrane. These two compartments are fitted with watertight frictionless pistons. Let's take pure solvent in the left compartment and a concentrated solution in the right compartment. So due to osmosis, there will be flow of solvent into the solution compartment through semi-permeable membrane. As a result, the piston on the solution side will tend to move outwards. To stop this movement of piston outwards, we have to apply pressure on the solution side. This pressure, just sufficient to stop osmosis, will be equal to the osmotic pressure. So thus, the excess pressure which must be applied to the solution side to prevent the passage of solvent into it through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmotic pressure. Van't Hoff observed that for dilute solutions, the osmotic pressure pi is equal to CRT, where C is the molar concentration of solution, that is molarity. Therefore, pi is proportional to C. Since osmotic pressure depends upon molar concentration of solution, and therefore it is a colligative property. In the formula, R represents the gas constant and T is the temperature in Kelvin. So our next topic is determination of molar mass of solute from osmotic pressure. So according to Van't Hoff equation, pi is equal to CRT. Let it be equation number 1. As we know, concentration is equal to number of moles per unit volume of solution. So where n is the number of moles of solute dissolved in V liters of solution. Therefore, pi is equal to n upon VRT. Let it be equation number 2. So as we know, number of moles of solute is equal to weight of solute divided by molecular weight, where WB is the weight of solute and capital MB is the molecular weight of solute. So by putting these values in equation 2, we get pi is equal to WB into RT divided by MB into V. So on rearranging this formula, we can calculate MB is equal to WB RT upon pi into V. Let it be equation number 3. Let's try one numerical based on colligative property osmotic pressure. A solution of sucrose whose molecular mass is given 342 gram per mole is prepared by dissolving 68.4 gram of it per liter of solution. What is the osmotic pressure at 300 Kelvin? So let's see what is given. Weight of solute WB is given 68.4 gram. Molecular mass of solute capital MB is also given 342 gram per mole. Volume of solution is 1 liter. Gas constant capital R is equal to 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Here temperature is 300 Kelvin. So according to Van 't Hoff equation, pi is equal to CRT, which is equal to N upon VRT, which is also equal to WB upon MB, RT upon V. This we can calculate earlier. So by putting the values, pi is equal to 68.4 into 0.082, that is R, into 300 Kelvin divided by 342 into 1 liter, that comes out to be 4.92 atmosphere. Always remember that you have to choose that value of R whose units are similar with the units of other quantities. That is, for example, in this numerical, volume of solution is given in liters, temperature in Kelvin, molecular mass in gram per mole. So we have chosen the value of R is as 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole, in which liter, Kelvin, mole, all are there. Let's discuss some terms related with the osmotic pressure. So first is isotonic solutions. The solutions which have the same osmotic pressure at the same temperature are called isotonic solutions or isoosmotic solutions. For example, 0.91% of sodium chloride solution, that is also called saline water, is isotonic with human blood corpuscles. That means red blood cells or WBCs. And second term is hypertonic solutions. If a solution has more osmotic pressure than other solution, it is called hypertonic solution. For example, 5% solution of NaCl is hypertonic to human blood corpuscles. And thus, the cells shrink in this solution. People taking a lot of salt in their diet can suffer from swelling or puffiness in their tissues, that is called edema, that is also due to the hypertonic nature of tissues. Third term is hypotonic solutions. If a solution has less osmotic pressure than other solution, it is called as a hypotonic solution. For example, 0.5% solution of NaCl is hypotonic to human blood corpuscles, and in this solution the cells swells up and burst. So osmosis plays a significant role in many biological functions or processes. Like osmosis plays a significant role in absorption of water by the plants through their roots, or the use of salt and sugar as preservatives in pickles prevent the growth of fungi and bacteria by osmosis. As I earlier said in topic difference between diffusion and osmosis, that the osmosis process can be reversed. So what is reverse osmosis? The process of movement of solvent through a semi-permeable membrane from the solution to the pure solvent side by applying excess pressure on solution side is called reverse osmosis. For example, desalination of seawater. The reverse osmosis process can be used for desalination of seawater for getting drinking water. So when a pressure greater than osmotic pressure is applied on the salty water of a semi-permeable membrane, the pure water flows from the salt water side to pure water side through semi-permeable. As a result, water is squeezed out of seawater, which does not contain any undesirable salts. So that's all with the colligative properties, and we have left with our last topic, that is abnormal molar masses. So please subscribe my channel and click the bell icon for further updates. Thanks for watching.